glamour and glitz for a new season of hybrid technology and new cars. But Seb Ogier gave the Monte a familiar start, winning both Thursday night stages. A new co-driver for the defending champion, the voice of Benjamin Vias, guiding the champ away from Lucerem in the Alpine darkness. And Seb Ogier led Seb Loeb by 6.7 seconds. First thing Friday, Adrien Formeau was matching Seb Ogier's rally-leading times, but he carried too much speed at this corner. The first big crash, the first big test of the new car's safety cell around which the new hybrid vehicle is built. But with the Frenchman and co-driver both out of the car, the protection cell inside the Puma had done its work. In seventh place, Gus Greensmith, after the best day of his career, that included his debut stage win. Friday's leader has a touch of nostalgia about it. Seb Loeb owned the event in the noughties. Now he had won everything in Friday's first loop, and one more stage in the afternoon. Seb and the Puma had taken us back in the hybrid future. Elvin Evans attacked Saturday's first run over Sistron, a stage that contained every sort of road condition. A compromise of studded and slick rubber for the Welshman, but once he got onto the dry tarmac, his tyres couldn't hold him and he was off. Ogier was the first to pass the scene, and from the road below, Evans' car could be seen clinging onto the bank above and to his left. Ogier then went on the charge, determined to win his ninth Monte Carlo rally, and took the lead off Loeb going into Sunday. Oit Tanak bet on soft rubber for Saturday morning, but not much of it. That was fine for the dry ascent, horrible on the perilous snow near the Sistron Col. He hit trouble, damaged the front of his I-20, and retired for the morning. Oliver Solberg's less than perfect weekend continued. He ditched his Hyundai on this lofty right-hand turn in stage 10. He freed himself, but he had dropped over half an hour off the lead. Thierry Nerval was in sixth place. A few kilometres into the stage 12, the damper exploded through the right side of Nerval's bonnet. Clever repairs got the Belgian over Sistron and safely back to overnight service. Carlo Rovanperä won the Monte Carlo end of rally power stage. Add those 5 points to the ones that he took for fourth place, and the young Finn had much to celebrate. What a weekend this was for Craig Breen in third. He enjoyed a rich weekend with their Monte Carlo gamble. He finished in third place. M Sport lead the Manufacturers' Championship now. Seb Ogier was leading until the penultimate stage when he got a puncture. Trying to make up the time, he had been too keen at the beginning of the power stage. He had jump-started it. He was punished with a 10-second penalty. Mission impossible, but because it was him, he almost pulled it off. So Seb Loeb took full advantage. An 80th WRC career victory at 47 years young, powering M Sport to a dream start alongside co-driver Isabelle Galmiche. Maths teacher by day, all adding up to a memorable Monte.
Bonjour, I feel really, really happy. I didn't expect so much when I came here, so it was a great fight. Ogier was really fast. I struggled a bit yesterday, even this morning.
Seb Loeb the victor, 19 years after his first Monte win. Close in the end. Had it not been for the 10-second penalty, it would have been very, very close. Breen makes it an M Sport Puma 1 and 3. Thierry Nerval, the best place Hyundai.